Lord gave me a little something to say, and my husband a big something to say. And he even had a vision. It was more than a dream. And he saw a little Bible on the table, and the pages were just waving, you know, and turning off. And then he said, I walked in there, and he saw me walking in. And I just thought, that was me. That was the Lord, I mean, my message. It's a little something, okay? But it's big when God, it's great when God's in it. Okay. April the 6th. You know, I thought my husband was getting better, and he would be coming home to one on this earth, our home, like quite a few times before. 2007 heart attack, 2008 pacemaker beginning, congestive heart failure with artery over 90% clogged, carotid artery over 90% clogged, E. coli trip, and his doctor said that he could have died that night. I just took it all for granted that he's going to come home. We were told he was stable right before he died. I look back and feel the Lord surely led me last Monday morning. Well, I thought about some things I needed to tend to, like something I needed to go to Walmart. But I said, no, go to the hospital. Then I thought about, I need a cup of coffee to wake me up. No, go to the hospital. I just felt the Lord tell me to go to the hospital. And so I was just sitting right there, and then I told you that part already. And so as I sat there beside the hospital bed, he seemed to be sleeping so deeply. No deep breathing, no coughing, no sounds whatsoever, just breathing. The Best Buy and the nurses and the doctor who came in could tell. But when the doctor did his routine check on him, he motioned for me to come over beside him. He turned to me and told me, I think he's gone on. I can't find any pulse. I said, bring him back, like I'd seen on TV. The doctor said he's gone. Well, yes, my husband had gone the biggest trip and greatest adventure ever. The one he really looked forward to. We can only imagine, like the song said. But we know Jesus told us in John 14. He said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. If it weren't so, I would have told you. So he's prepared a place. And so he says he's going to come back for us. Praise and honor and glory be to God forever. One time, as I was walking into our house, I thought, life is so short. Being I was a senior citizen, the Lord told me, but you live forever. You have eternal life. It's not life is not short. Okay, when with Jesus as my Lord and Savior, I have eternal life right now and forever. April the 7th, Saturday about 6 a.m. Remembering, Dr. Nishin told us recently that he had dodged the bullets. Well, Brother Edmund said today he came by the house and he said, well, he ran ahead to heaven. Then Brother Robin said something like this, that Brother Riggins hadn't stopped running yet. Thank you, Jesus. And so I want to read about Ecclesiastes. It's hard for me to pronounce those words now, but this while he was in the hospital, for some reason, I read Ecclesiastes. I just kept reading it. And so you know what it is. To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. That was God's time. I believe it with all my heart. Because he said he was looking forward to going to heaven. And everyone would just like to go to sleep and go to heaven. So he got his desire. And he definitely did not want to go to a nursing home and lay and dwindle away like his daddy did. And he was even talking to Mark. Mark got to figuring it out that he's worried about that. And so Mark talked to him the night before he died that you're not going to go to a nursing home. You know, you're going to go home. Of course, he did go home, but the one up there. So then it says a time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to have. A time to have. A time of war and a time of peace. What profit has he that worketh in that wherein he labored? I have seen the travail which God hath given to the sons of men to be exercised in it. This is one of my favorite scriptures here. He hath made everything beautiful in his time. Also, he hath set the world in their heart, so that no man can find out the work that God maketh from the beginning to the end. I know that there is no good thing in them, but for a man to rejoice and to do good in his life, and also that every man should eat and drink and enjoy the good of all his labor. It is the gift of God. I know that whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever. Nothing can be put to it, nor anything taken from it. And God doeth it, and men should fear before him. That which hath been is now, and that which is to be hath already been. And God requireth that which is past. And I'm just about finished. And whatsoever I saw under the sun, the place of judgment, that wickedness was there, and the place of righteousness, that iniquity was there. You know, in other words, you know, the devil is going to be after you. And so you might as well make up your mind, you're going to serve God, and nothing's going to stop you whatsoever. Nothing's going to stop you.
Glory to God.
You can just expect trouble and everything. Because the Bible says that man is born woman is going to see trouble. But you know what? God is with us.
Amen.
He's bigger than our trouble. Yes. He's bigger than anything. He's perfect. He makes no mistakes. And then, back to the Bible. I said in mine heart, God shall judge the righteous and the wicked. For there is a time there for every purpose. And for every work, I said in my heart concerning the estate of the sons of men that God might manifest them and that they might see that they themselves are beasts. For that which befalleth the sons of men befalleth beasts. Even one thing befalleth them. As the one dieth, so dieth the other. Yea, they have all one breath, so that a man hath no preeminence above a beast. For all is vanity. All go into one place. All are of the dust, and all turn to dust again. Who knoweth the spirit of man that goeth upward, and the beast, the spirit of the beast that goeth downward in the earth? Wherefore, I perceive that there's nothing better than that a man should rejoice in his own work, for that is his purpose, portion. For who shall bring him to see what shall be after him? And you know, all of y'all know that this one said, all's vanity. He just saw that everything, it's really just nothing. But God is everything.
Amen.
And so, praise the Lord. So I just kept on reading that, and I just thank God for it, because it's so precious. But then I was looking for pictures, and it was so fitting. And I hope y'all don't mind me reading it. But I used to write, the Lord give me things. I'd be washing dishes, and all the ones I'd have to go and write something down. And you know what I'm talking about, the ones of you that you let God speak to you. Because if you'll be still, you'll see God. You'll see the salvation, praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. And it's really hard for me to see up here, because I need to get my glasses changed. I'm really having a hard time. So, this was written in 1977. As Jesus passed by, I've seen the faces of people, wretched and sad and poor within. I've seen the peace of God as their souls were cleansed from sin. I've seen the hand of Jesus touch people as they pass by. I've seen the joy of the Lord upon a face. I've seen the saints. I've heard them shout as they sang Amazing Grace. I've seen a little child as he came up for prayer. And I saw him throw down his braces, like I did see that on television. Old Robert, a little child came for prayer, and he threw down his braces and saw they did, you know, took them off, and he was running and happy. Okay. And I've seen people dancing, and their feet would pound the floor. And I've never seen anyone who was blessed by the God that didn't want more. But the sight of all I'm looking for is when Jesus splits the sky, and I want to be flying as Jesus passes by. I want my hand to touch his hand. I know he won't let go. As a blood-bought child of his, my soul is white as snow. I want my garments of spotless. I want to keep my heart clean within. I want to be ready when Jesus comes again.
Yes.
I can see the clouds yonder in the sky. I can see the glory that shall pierce every eye. Oh, the glory is too wonderful of a soul that's free from sin. Oh, the glory of Jesus coming yonder again. Like a diamond in the sky as it sparkles for every eye. Oh, the brilliance of that moment that Jesus passes by. Can't you just see that? It's hard to read these words, it faded out. Can't you just see that loving hand that took the dust of the earth and molded and made us in his image and breathed us in a man's nostrils? And he came a living soul. Can't you see that hand as a grasping hand of man reaches up to touch his hand? Oh, miracles of miracles, as a loving God above that Wicked a man can go, he cannot outrun the Lord and the touch of God's love. Got a little bit more, but I tell you, I should have. I need a light up here. Well, this is the end of it here. Yes, I've seen the faces changed as Jesus passed by. I've seen faces filled with hope and troubled hearts that were broken as they were mended back together again. I've seen wrecked, broken, ruined lives that had no hope for even today. Get up and walk again and travel on for God. I've seen them become mighty warriors for the Lord. I've seen them march on and never retreat again. Yes, I've seen what God can do as he passes by.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. And then, you know, I wrote, this was a little book I wrote down, people, you know, and on June the 6th, 1977, and called Shannon Hills then. And there were 39 people in there that day. And our and it makes me real sad if I read all the names and everything. But anyway, we had some very, very wonderful services. And I just praise God because he's so good to us. And could y'all send me read one more?
Absolutely.
I hope.
Yes.
Because this one, and this one's in darker ink. Okay. August the 20th, 1977. God meant it for good for me. Sometimes I wonder why some things didn't happen a long time ago for me. But then these thoughts start coming forth to me. God's time is perfect and the ways are right, for I see you meant it for, the old devil meant it for evil, but God meant it for good for me. When the devil brings a curse, a tormenting me, I know my God can turn it into a blessing as easy as can be. You meant it for evil, but God meant it for good for me. So, we'll wait through the night for the answers to our prayers to come. We'll not grow weary, nor will we faint on the way. For weeping comes in the night, but rejoicing comes when it's day. Mm. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
If we do not see God's stars, they are still there. If we do not see Jesus, he is still standing near.
Yes.
He that said, I'll never leave thee nor forsake thee, he surely stands with me. I know God's true. I know he answers my prayers. I've got a lot of answers, and I know the rest are on the way. I'll not give up no matter how hot the test, for when I'm tried as by fire, I shall come forth as gold, because I'm sheltered in the arms of God.
Amen.
And thank y'all for letting me share this with you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.